Alright, so there's you just watching YouTube, and you stumble upon this guy showcasing his sick full body tracking VR setup. You can't help but wonder how you can replicate such a baller setup. The guy in the video is using a slime VR kit, which is affordable at 165 bucks compared to the 300 or more you spend on Vive trackers for the same purpose. But that's just way out of your budget. You then remember the Kinect exists, which can be had for around 30 of your preferred currency, and many people do use it for body tracking already. But what if you had zero money? How good of an experience can you get? Well, pretty fucking good actually. Before anyone mentions it, zero money includes not paying for software at all. I am perfectly aware that Driver 4VR works, but the tracking has been pretty bad from my personal experience, and I just ended up refunding it. I am making this tutorial because there are barely any for the free and open source alternatives to it. Let's go over the physical requirements first, and I'll talk about software in a second. Obviously, I'm talking about VR stuff, so you're gonna have to have a headset and shit. You might already have the stuff, but a trip to the local Chinese-owned business will sort you out. Some glue, a stapler, a Sharpie's optional. You will need a printer that prints out stuff. These are not the ones you need to print out. And you will need some Amazon boxes. Amazon is optional. You also need some of this fucking elastic shit.
Yeah.
Just get this, alright? Also, you need some kind of webcam, half-decent one works, PS3i works, or you can just use a phone. I'll get into that later. Alright, onto software. Our main player here will be April-Tag-VR-FullBody-Tracker. I'll be using this in conjunction with owoTrack. The second one will be entirely for hip tracking. It is optional as AprilTag will track your hips if set up to do so, however, it does work better. The main developer of AprilTag says that they will be adding virtual hip support, so this might be entirely unnecessary in the future. Alright, so with that out of the way, head on over to the GitHub page of AprilTag, go into releases, and download the latest one. You can save it wherever you want, as long as you don't lose it later. Alright, once you've extracted that folder, head on over to the images print folder. This contains, surprisingly, the images you will need to print. You can print either 450 or 475 sets. There's one for the front, and there's one for the back. These front trackers will be the ones that obviously go in the front, and the back trackers are completely optional, as they will be used for 360 instead of just 180 degree tracking. I recommend you print the first one, try it out, and do the other one later. The wiki has this nice guide which shows that these first two are for your waist, these two are for one leg, and these two are for another. If you're planning on using another application, such as owoTrack, like me, to track your waist, you will not need to print out this first row, saving you on some black ink. Unless, like me, you're printing it out for free at the university, in which case you might as well print the other page. You do not actually have to print out this Chiruko board PDF, you can later display it on a monitor. It will be used to calibrate a camera. Alright, so, it's time for arson crafts. I've already printed out two of these. One for leg one front, and one for leg two front. You basically want to have them looking like this. Bend a cardboard, 90 degrees, random piece of cardboard, 90 degrees, and add some glue in the middle for these triangles to keep them rigid. Okay, you should grab some elastic thing. Clamp it down with staples, because it's way better than glue. And yeah, pretty solid. I'll make two more of these.
Go get your squares printed, retrieve them, and cut them up into slices of two. Keep in mind the image and write on the back which one is which so you don't get confused.
So, print out those things. They will look like this. I don't want to print them out again, but basically just cut them into horizontal stripes, like such. I have labeled them according to the image on the wiki, waist front. This one's leg two back, this one's leg one back, and this one's waist back. You might be wondering where leg one and leg two are. They are right here because I've already made them. I'm not going through the trouble of making them again just for a video. Alright, so take your cardboard, take your cutouts, and just cut approximately where you need them to be. Thank you.
Alright, cut out a sample of cardboard, just bend it down the middle. Fucking thing on it, check where the middle is. And just kind of bend it. Doesn't it really have to be perfect? Obviously, it's just a paper plate. Alright, so now I have a 90 degree-ish piece of cardboard. Grab some more cardboard and cut some triangles out. Glue down on the cardboard. And just plastic. Got something to hold it in place. In my case, it is a power bank and a tape measure.
Wait a couple minutes for the glue to dry. Meanwhile, I could just make more triangles, keep sticking it to them, add more glue, etc., etc. Just keep going until they're solid.
Well, my phone overheated and stopped recording, so I had to put it in the freezer. Anyways, I'll show you these two that I've already made. I'll be making these two into back leg trackers. Leg two back and leg to the front. Make sure to label a sharp one. Again, the back trackers are completely optional. So, leg one back on two, leg one back. Get it in the seam, down the middle. Glue on the cardboard. Alright, so now you probably have 2, 4, or 6 trackers. These two are required, the front leg trackers, back leg trackers, and the hip front and back trackers, which I don't have. I'll be using my phone for it.
Alright, for this part, just grab your legs, put the fucking thing in it, and measure out how much string you'll need. So yeah, grab the required amount of string and fucking staple it to the thing, and yeah, you're pretty much done. Nice. Alright, let's sort out a camera situation. Obviously, the higher resolution and the higher frame rate will give you a better tracking experience. I'll be trying it out using a phone over USB, hello, and totally overkill, I'll just use my camera connected to a capture card. I know that the point of this video is in $0 budget, or close to it, but this is what I have. I haven't spent any extra on it. I'll be trying it out with the PS3i first. It is super incredibly cheap. I pay like 2 or 3 euros for this. And if you're using your phone as a hip tracker or for recording a fucking YouTube video, you obviously can't be using it to track your trackers. So let's set this up first. If you've never used a PS3i camera, there's plenty of tutorials online. I'm not exactly going to cover this. Download the firmware that works for you, install it, and plug in your camera. All right, so if you've installed your drivers correctly, try it out in OBS. Open a video capture device, choose PS3i Universal, custom resolution 640 by 480 and 60 FPS. Nice. So, kind of shitty quality, but
provided you have lots and lots of light, it is real 60 FPS video. Nice.
Swiki lists a couple things you can use to stream your phone to your computer. They recommend IP webcam. I don't personally go with that. My favorite would be SCRCPY. Let me show you. Go on the GitHub page and download the latest release. Extract this somewhere nice and go in its respective folder. Next up, you want to plug your phone into your computer and find out how to enable USB debugging on your specific model of phone. If prompted to trust the computer, make sure to press yes. Next up, open up a command prompt window in this directory. Type in SCRCPY. Right, so your phone's being streamed now. Open up the camera app. Switch it to video mode. In order to use this as a webcam, we're going to use OBS. OBS has shipped a virtual camera since quite a few versions ago, so you should be able to use that to stream your phone camera. Make a new scene, add a video capture, select SCRCPY, and make it fit. Alright, now all you have to do is start the virtual camera, and it's ready to be used in any application. Nice. If you want to stream your phone screen wirelessly, head on over to the developer options again. Turn on wireless debugging. Trust this network. Write down that IP address and port. Close out of SCRCPY. Same command prompt window, type in ADV and the IP address you just noted. It's connected. Open up SCRCPY again. Give me an error because I'm connected to both of my phone over wired and wireless. I'll just unplug my phone. And there we go. It's completely wireless. Nice. With everything printed out and assembled, all your cameras set up, let's go back to the first folder we downloaded. First things first, you want to install the driver files. Go to the appropriately named folder and click the appropriately named executable. Mine's already installed, so I just press enter to continue. Go back up a directory and run the batch file. Now we need to go change some parameters. First thing you want to change is the ID of the camera. Each camera is assigned a number from 0 to 10, and you basically have to guess which one is the correct one. My ID 1 was Snap Camera, and my ID 0 was actually the one I wanted to use. Now this default resolution is obviously not what I want, so I had to manually change it to 1280 by 720 at 60 FPS. The next parameter you want to set is the number of trackers. I'll be using 2, one on each leg, but I'll set it as 3. If your setup is like mine, make sure to check the box, ignore tracker 0, unless you're using this program as a hip tracker. Now just grab your camera and point it at the thing. You want to try and get as many angles as possible. It takes one picture every second, so I just kind of did it for about a minute. When that's done, just press OK. Now you need to calibrate your trackers. Grab your fine works of craftsmanship and put one in each leg. You should see one green and one purple square on each leg. The green means it's calibrated and can be used to calibrate other markers, and the purple means that you have to move it closer. So, move your legs closer to about 30 centimeters away from the camera, and they should turn yellow. Hold them still for a couple seconds, and they will both turn green. The last step is to open up SteamVR and press the Connect to SteamVR button. If you boot up in SteamVR at home, make sure to exit it before proceeding. Finally, the not so fun part. There is now a white camera visible in your play space, and you must use this interface to match it up with roughly the location of a camera in real life. The recommended way to do this is to put one of your controllers on top of the camera and match it up roughly from there. Alright, if you look down and see your feet roughly where your feet are, that's how you know it's good. So So you can now close out of April tags and we can set up owoTrack. This last one is really straightforward. Just join the Discord, follow the setup guide yourself. I can't be bothered to repeat their instructions. Download it on your phone, download the client for Windows, and open it up. It will boot up SteamVR for you, annoying. Just install the driver and restart SteamVR. The instructions are laid out clearly in front of you, so I don't know how you can miss these. It's good practice to turn on your controllers before you do anything else, so I'll just go ahead and do that. Just press the obvious button that says pawn and open up the app on your phone. It should automatically pick it up. If not, just type in the IP address. Again, they're simple on-screen instructions. First do the figure eight thing, then put your phone up to your forehead basically, and then calibrate it in your pants. Once that's done, you should look down and find a tracker on your hips, roughly. Nice job. Yo, nice going, man. Should have everything set up and working now. I recommend you do things in this order. First open SteamVR, then pair your controllers, then open AprilTags and start that, and then start owoTrack. In VR chat, you can see three balls below you, one for each foot, one for your hips. Head on over to a world with a mirror so you can calibrate your avatar. This is pretty straightforward, just align your real life feet, represented by the ball, with your avatar's feet, and press both triggers while T-posing. So, there it is, with a budget of roughly zero, you now have full-ish body tracking. Nice job!